Okay, so usually I'd be wearing a hat, but I mean, I just put all my hats away. I mean, like, I just put them away. So, you're gonna have to deal with this mess today. You're just... sorry. Hey, hey, it's Jay Gray. Welcome back to Wing It Wednesday. Today, we are comparing religion sins. The sins of religions. Sorry, the sins of Christianity and Satanism. It's kind of like how we were comparing the rules a few weeks ago, except this time, it's the sins. Okay, so, first things first, what are they? I'm gonna go through the Christianity ones. I'm just gonna be listing them off and being like, yeah, okay, cool. So, Christians. Christianity. The seven deadly sins, as we all know them. Although, there were originally eight. Yeah. What's that? Christians are brushing off some things like they never existed and taking the rest for gospel? And the things that they take for gospel are, wow, it says this, so we must obey, we must listen to it, we must follow it, you know, because it says it. But, you know, then totally contradicting themselves and being complete and utter hypocrites, because what about those other things that it also says? Christians don't do that. As if they would have done that again. I am shocked. Right, so, the seven deadly sins, as I said, we all have at least heard of them, right? There's pride, greed, lust, envy, gluttony, wrath, and sloth. Yeah? And then there's that, you know, that eighth one that they're sort of brushing off now. And that was sadness or sorrow or despair, depending on which translation you want to look at, was the eighth. So, yeah, being sad was a sin. That's fun. That's really fun. Christians make me laugh. They're so amusing. I love you guys. I love you. I really just, the world would be so much less fun without you. I mean, there'd also be a lot less war, and a lot less hate, and a lot less discrimination, all that kind of shit, but, I mean, where would the fun be? Where would people find their bloody entertainment without these Christians? Alright, and now we have Satanism! The nine satanic rules, which are a bit less heard of, because, I mean, they don't push these on children, they don't try to brainwash kids with these, so, I mean... bit of a different story here. Alright, so the first thing on the list is stupidity. Self-explanatory. Pretentiousness. Again, self-explanatory. Solipsism. I'm not even sure I'm saying that right. Sorry, we all know I suck at pronouncing things. This is projecting your reactions, responses, and sensibilities onto someone who is probably far less attuned than you are. It is the mistake of expecting people to give you the same consideration, courtesy, and respect that you naturally give them. Nice. Just thought I'd explain that one a bit, because a lot of people are going to be like, what the fuck does that mean? That's what it means. I only read half of the thing, but you get the point. Number four, self-deceit. Five, herd conformity. Yes, I said it right that time. Six, lack of perspective. You must never lose sight of who and what you are, and what a threat you can be by your very existence. That is deep. That is so deep. Seven, forgetfulness of past orthodoxies. I may have said that wrong. That's just something that happens with me. You come onto my channel, you are just going out of your way to hear me mispronounce things. Or maybe I pronounced it right, we'll never know. Be aware that this is one of the keys to brainwashing people into accepting something new and different, when in reality it's something that was once widely accepted but is now presented in a new package. We are expected to rave about the genius of the creator and forget the original. This makes for a disposable society. Now that one, and I'm not going to say that this is everyone's view on it, but I mean, I got like this sort of little bit of a hint that they were sort of subtly throwing shade at Christianity. So, good work. 8. Counterproductive pride. I'm going to read this one to you as well because it's just... The first word is important. Pride is great up to the point you begin to throw the baby out with the bathwater. The first rule of Satanism is, if it works for you, great. When it stops working for you, when you've painted yourself into a corner and the only way out is to say, I'm sorry, I made a mistake, I wish we could compromise somehow, then do it. I love that. That is... And number 9, lack of aesthetics. I love that that's a sin. Lack of aesthetics. This is the physical application of the balance factor. Aesthetics is important in lesser magic and should be cultivated. It is obvious that no one can collect any money off classical standards of beauty and form most of the time, so they are discouraged in a consumer society. But an eye for beauty, for balance, is an essential satanic tool and must be applied for greatest magical effectiveness. It's not what's supposed to be pleasing, it's what is. Aesthetics is a personal thing, reflective of one's own nature, but there are universally pleasing and harmonious configurations that should not be denied. I love that. I do really like the satanic sins. They're lovely. And I love the phrasing and like the logic behind them too. It's just, Don't even get me started on this. So here we go, guys. Thanks for watching this. This was me comparing the rules of Christianity and Satanism, or at least telling you what they are in case you weren't aware, and about how fun they are, and making fun of Christians again. Sorry. Not really. You watch a video on my channel about religion, I'm gonna be making fun of Christians. Alright, it's just inevitable. Not in a mean way, just yeah. Thanks for watching this. If there's anything you want to see in the future, let me know. Don't forget to go and vote for Winger Wednesday next week. And don't forget to check out my cover channel and Queer as a Deer. And I'll see you next week. Stay awesome.